I've just adjusted the lighting on that camera a fraction because it seemed a little bit overexposed, didn't it? Good evening, everybody, and welcome to your favourite place on a Sunday evening, on a Sunday afternoon, and perhaps in some cases on a Sunday morning. Virtual Church here on Beauty in Sound. We are today using the virtual organ of Saint-Ouen in Rouen in France, where there is a sensational Kvaikal four manual, very romantic organ with all of the colours of the orchestra on it. And I love playing it. In fact, truth be told, I had Dari round here just on Friday, the day before yesterday, recording something for BIS. She's a Ukrainian organist, and she did a recital today at Westminster Abbey. And while she was here in England, she sent me a message saying she'd like to meet me. And I said, well, I'd like to meet you too. So she was here playing this wonderful organ. So I've left it set up. I thought, I know who else would like to hear this organ. You lot. So here we are in virtual Saint-Ouen. So the first request today came in from Peter Bethwaite, who requested the same hymn twice, but then he realised actually he'd requested the wrong hymn tune. The words were Sing My Tongue, Sing My Tongue, The Glorious Battle, which obviously normally goes to the wonderful plain song. But actually Peter wanted it to the tune Tantum Ergo, which you had. He said it's a great Passiontide hymn. Well, it is, isn't it? We're not quite a Passiontide yet, but we are very nearly there. In fact, this time next week, we'll be on Palm Sunday. Wow, oh yes, Palm Sunday. Now, the next request comes in from Brady Kilman, who requests, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Listen to this, guys. I've got a one of, so we have a few producers who work behind the scenes, like Josh and James. They normally do it. And James has just said, the background ambient sound is sounding a bit like a lawnmower. So those people who don't know what a lawnmower is, that's basically something that cuts your backyard, you know, electric lawnmower type thing. Really, is it that? Does it sound like a lawnmower? If it sounds like a lawnmower, that is quite hilarious, but we will change it if it does, because that's not quite the sort of sound I was going for. So this next tune is called Nettleton. Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. And it is a request from Brady Kilman. Just hopefully now this camera up here isn't overexposed. Fingers crossed. Thank you. I should say that at the very end of VC tonight, we'll have a French voluntary, a big French voluntary by a French composer you may have heard of called Louis Vierne. Not his finale from the First Symphony, but certainly from one of the symphonies. It would be rude to have this organ on, playing this organ, but not do a French organ piece, wouldn't it? So, a bit of Vienne coming up later. And also a piece of organ music requested by Glenn Snyder, some Bach as well on this organ, which I haven't played for a while. So, coming, let's go into our third request tonight, because we actually have 12 requests to get through before we get into our top five tonight, which tonight comes in from Christopher Nelson, who sent this on the 18th of October, 2022. So Chris, if you're watching live tonight, I think you are, I really apologize for it taking so long, but I hope it's worth the wait. Carmen Foster sent in three requests this week. But Carmen has been a member of our community for a while and is very generous, so I'll indulge these three requests tonight. He says that we're celebrating the 206th birthday of the author Fanny Crosby this week. Didn't know that. And he requested a hymn called Jesus, Keep Me Near the Cross. So this is our third request this evening, and it's in a 6/8 meter, so a sort of a dancing, lilting meter, which we were discussing last week. See early episodes if you want to find out more about that. It's Jesus, keep me near the cross. There, a precious fountain, free to all, a healing stream, flows from Calvary's mountain. And then the chorus, in the cross, be my glory ever, till my ransomed soul shall find rest beyond the river. And the tune is called Near the Cross, and the words are by Fanny Crosby. There's a beautiful cornet on the re si, on the swell on this organ. So let's explore that for a moment, shall we? Here we go.
See.
Jesus, keep me near the cross. There, a precious fountain. So, how are you all today? Well done. Oh, I forgot to enter into the tip jar. Oh, should I enter the tip jar? I'll do that. It looks like it's overflowing, as Maurice once said. It's like leaving the washing out on the side in the kitchen. Which we never do that. It's left two in there for some reason, I don't know. But that's a bit cleaner now, Maurice, isn't it? If anybody wants to add any in there, please be my guest. That would be great if you could. Near the cross there, requested by Carmen Foster. By the way, on the BIS shop, BIS online store, there is a new product you can buy. I've got a new series. Well, it's not new anymore, but it's the BIS Cathedral Organ Series. So there was in England a great cathedral organ series done decades ago now, which came out on LP, featuring such wonderful organists as Francis Jackson, Noel Rawsthorne at Liverpool, Roger Fisher at Chester, all of these organists from a previous generation, probably a couple of generations ago actually. And I'm now going through the cathedrals again, if I can. I'm not sure how many we'll get through. Wouldn't it be nice to have them all? The BIS Great Cathedral Organ Series. And I've actually, I think, have done nearly 10, I think. So the last one that is online, the latest online, is Llandaff in Wales. So if you want to buy the Llandaff Cathedral, Great Cathedral Organ Series, it's on the BIS shop. You can buy a CD, or you can buy the lossless audio download. And you do get compression on YouTube, I'm sorry to say, but you do, and it's very annoying because the video quality on YouTube is tremendous. You know, the 4K videos that we put online are just tremendous, you can't fault them. But the audio just doesn't match up to it. But if you download the audio from my shop, you're essentially getting it in lossless, which means it's as high a quality as possible. £10 to download, or I think £12 for a CD. A bit of a bargain. So, next hymn is a request from Daniel Kubacki. Hello, Daniel. He says, I love this tune. Ha! This doesn't really make sense, Daniel, but I know what you mean. I love this tune, Googling British Lenten hymns. You think you love this tune, which you found after you have been Googling British Lenten hymns. I fell in love with it as soon as I heard it. What a hymn, he says. Well, it's Be Thou My Guardian and My Guide, and hear me when I call. Let not my slippery footsteps slide. A bit of opportunity there for the 32-foot flute, bit of rumble. Feet sliding. And hold me lest I fall. The tune is called A Bridge, and it's by Isaac Smith. The words by Isaac Williams. So here we go. Let's go to Be Thou My Vision. Sorry, Be Thou My Guardian and My Guide.
Thank you.
thou my guardian and my guide there. Verse 2, the world, the flesh, and Satan dwell around the path I tread. Oh, save me from the snares of hell. And quickener of the dead. Can't do that on the real organ. Just pull off the stop. Head. Oh, thanks, Daniel, for sending that through. Next hymn comes in from Benjamin Yao. I think Benjamin's been enjoying a well-deserved break from doing the timestamps. And I should say at this point, thank you very much to Bill Ratey, who has stepped in very, very ably and has done some wonderful time stamping for the last couple of virtual churches. Benjamin, you've done a lot, so feel free just to step back for a while. If anybody else would like to help with the keeping track of the times of each hymn in virtual church, that would be really, really appreciated. And it just means that when you watch it back during the week, you can actually click the time you want in the description and it will jump straight to that moment in the video. So if the fifth hymn is your favourite hymn, you click it, you can go straight to it without having to fast forward through all this waffle. Because I know none of you come here for waffle. So Benjamin has sent in a hymn. It's Here Is Love, vast as the ocean, loving kindness as the flood. When the Prince of Life, our ransom, shed for us his precious blood. He says, to append your Welsh-centric VC last week, which we had, you know, for Llandaff and lots of Welsh hymns and the Llandaff Cathedral organ, here's a Welsh hymn that is involved in the Welsh revival of 1904 to 1905, but commonly sung to a tune composed by the American Robert Lowry. Well, I didn't know anything about this Welsh revival of 1904 to 1905. But this is to a Welsh tune called Cymraeg, C-Y-M-R-A-E-G. I think that almost certainly is not how you pronounce that word. Hopefully someone will correct me. And it's a really gorgeous tune. Three verses. And what should we have? Should we have a solo? Yeah, that's a solo. Yeah, a solo. But let's have a swell, a resi hautbois with a flute, I think, a la, you know, César Franck, prelude fugue variation perhaps, and then we'll go from there, see how we get on with that. Quiet's great, quiet's a pedal, great to pedal. Cool, well, here we go. Love is, here is love, fast as the ocean. Thank you. Bill, one of my favorite stops of all time. That one. Particularly if it's played up the octave, where it really is very rich.
Is that the flute harmonique?
Yeah. So, a lot of you will know this, but an 8-foot flute harmonique is actually, for some of the keyboard, 16-foot. So, essentially, it's double length. And you can hear it, so the lower parts will be 8-foot, normal pitch length. And then this top half of the keyboard will be double length, because you've got double the pipe for double the sound, but the correct pitch, which is why it's so warm. Let's see if we can hear where it switches from 16 foot to 8 feet. Okay, so we'll start from the bottom and work upwards. Hear that, the break there, where it's suddenly almost doubled in tone. Gorgeous, aren't they? Really gorgeous stops. So that was Here Is Love, Vast as the Ocean. It's nice to actually play this monstrous organ rather quietly and delicately, because this organ does loud and growly very well. As you'll notice later on in the voluntary, if you stick around.
Good Chappie asks, does the organ still have summer tuning?
This is the... yeah. Well, winter tuning. Well,
winter tuning.
Well, yeah, it's basically the tuning that comes out of the box. So I haven't really changed the tuning. I don't think I might have done.
It wasn't there that the other year at Winchester they had to take some windows out in winter to.
They had
to take some windows out to do something.
Yeah.
Oh, they were finishing the roof, weren't they, in the choir? And they took the scaffolding out through a window, and the organ went completely haywire because it was so cold.
Well, that's what happens to the, yeah.
And then there was the infamous time when you went to play it and the scaffolding person had left a ladder propped against one of the 32-foot reeds and caused it to cipher. Do you remember that? And so you turned the organ on to start evensong practice and it was deciphering.
That was fun. And not, we didn't get to use the organ much that day because it was deciphering on bottom D on this note.
That was the same thing, wasn't it? It was all the same timing.
Turn the organ on and that note ciphered. So can't do much with that. Dyson and D, perhaps. Anyway, so up next is a request from Alan Matthew, who's requested Just As I Am Without One Plea, But That Your Blood Was Shed For Me, And That You Call Us, Come To Me, O Lamb of God, I Come. He says, had this at a joint service today, but played on the piano. Need to hear this in all its organ glory. Well, you've got a big French cavaille call and at our disposal here. So yes, I think we should have a bit of fun in this. I have, annoyingly, I've actually only got the first three verses, so I don't know what the words are to the second half of the hymn. There it is. I'll play it from the hymn book.
Daniel Kibaki, no, not Dyson the Hoover guy. It's a different, it's George Dyson. Dyson the Hoover guy did not compose Dyson and D Evening Canticles. Just to clear that up. Different Dyson.
Yeah. Yeah. It's an easy mistake to make. Right, so, Saffron Walden, Just As I Am Without One Plea.
Thank you.
So I just had a quick note from James, my producer, to say there's a slight misbalance in volume output which when cams switch between overhead and side. Let me have a quick look at that.
It's only marginal.
I can't see where that would be, James. Does anyone else notice that? Has anyone else noticed a difference in volume when I'm going to switch cameras? As long as it's not a big issue, it's not. It doesn't really bother me.
Overhead camera's louder than side, apparently.
So how is everyone today? I can see lots of people chatting away. It's always good. I can see bodies making people laugh, which is nice. We've got over 220 people, which is lovely to have so many people here. Paul?
And
Brady,
Antino's in
and
sunny Antino, Spain.
And Daniel, look at you, and Antino.
Sunny
I tell
Spain.
You
it's
what,
sunny
and Antino.
Here.
We've had so much rain here. Honestly, it's getting depressing.
Rich is very depressed because he's got a new bike, and ever since he's had his new bike, it's rained every day.
Yeah, I went out on the bike a few times, and every time I've been out on the bike, I just get absolutely soaked. I think it's just my luck. I've not ridden a bike for absolutely years, and I've actually got a bike. I thought I'm going to be healthy. Can I get on the bike? As soon as I get the bike, weeks of rain, weeks. Someone's telling me somewhere you don't need to do any exercise. I do, but I am running a little bit of a hot off the press bit of information. I do go running every Monday, every Wednesday, and every Friday. Well, I say every. You know what I mean when I say every, right? I try to.
Lewis Harvey spent Choral Evensong tonight watching from the organ loft at Liverpool Cathedral.
Wow.
He said
fantastic.
It was quite something.
Who was playing?
Who was playing, Lewis? He hasn't said.
Oh, fantastic. Now, Carmen has requested a hymn, as usual. Now, I'm going to have to just do a little bit of something clever here. I'm going to have to do the old thing of having two hymn books open. So number 59 in the Complete Anglican for the tune. No, for the words.
You've got you hymn and then books for the tonight. That's very 20th century of you.
Well, I know. I'm prepared. You know, I do spend a long time preparing these VCs. And I knew that when I came to this particular hymn, I would have to use a hymn book and the iPad. Simply because I could not, for love nor money, find anywhere on the internet a scan of the words and these tune together. So Carmen wanted, awake our souls, away our fears, let every trembling thought be gone. Awake and run the heavenly race and put a cheerful courage on.
Hi, Bobby.
Bobby's here. And the tune is called Samson, and it's from, I guess, the oratorio Samson by George Frederick Handel. And this is very similar to the tune, you know, the tune to the words, Jesus shall reign wherever the sun. It's very similar to that, and I think that, I forget what tune that, I think, is it called Truro? I think that tune might have taken its inspiration from this tune. See what you think. Let me know whether you can see any similarities in the two tunes. So here we go. Awake our souls, away our fears.
Ian Garden thinks it is Truro.
Listen. The iron herder drifted off into a nap. I don't know whether that's a compliment or a criticism.
Thank you.
Well, I'm sorry to say that there does appear to be a bit of a sound discrepancy between some of the camera angles. I'm not quite sure why. I don't know why it would happen. So it's a side camera and quiet.
It's quiet.
Oh, quiet. Side camera is quieter. Overhead cam is louder. This side camera is quieter. This one is quieter. Can't see why, because all the levels are the same. I have to do a little bit of digging around. And last week it wasn't an issue, and I haven't actually changed anything since last week in terms of sound. It's very strange. Can't think what that would be. If I mute that. Was there a discrepancy then when I did that? Because, and so on the screen here, the levels don't change at all when I change the camera angle. So that's quite hard for me to diagnose, actually. Very interesting. Anyway, hopefully it won't. So I'll tell you what. Let's just not go to the top camera quite so regularly then.
Okay.
So that was, who was requested that? Carmen. James Mossop is up next with a really great hymn, this one. We might have to have a bit of Rawsthorn, actually.
Oh, right.
With this one.
Rawsthorn in Lent, goodness.
Yeah, well, it's sort of this is a bit of a naughty hymn, really. This is more appropriate for...
Oh, Folder.
Yeah, it's a Palm Sunday type thing, isn't it?
But this is a good hymn.
So James Mossop requested it. He says, I played this hymn as the last hymn this morning. Oh, he even did. There we go. This is actually makes it relevant to do a little bit of Rawsthorn. And James also did his own variation on the last verse. It is, we have a gospel to proclaim. Good news for all throughout the earth. The gospel of a saviour's name. We sing his glory, tell his worth. There we go. So... Yes, Bill, at least there isn't a quarter minute delay. That was annoying, wasn't it?
And
never worked that one out, actually.
Maurice is upset that you're losing the top camera because he could see that you'd combed your hair specially.
Well, I will agree to that. I did brush it, actually. At about 5 to 8 tonight, I did actually brush it. I was just getting myself groomed. Ready, because I know how much you like appearances. And to be honest with you, there's only so much I can do to this temple. Not that much. We have a gospel to proclaim. Let's have a read. I'll tell you what read we haven't had yet as a solo read. Let's push all those in. Let's pull that one out.
Maurice is giving you a clap for the hairbrush.
Here we go. Thank you.
No, it's very growly.
Well, let's tell of that glorious Easter morn, empty the tomb, for he was free, but then he broke the power of death and hell. That we might share his victory. You can only play that verse in one way. So that's obviously, we'll have lots more of that over the coming weeks, of that hymn.
Oh no, poor Andrew. He was playing the organ this morning, yep. And he got caught out by the clock change. Just
Andrew.
Got back from holiday.
Oh, hello, Andrew.
Andrew. I can't imagine you'd be caught out by anything.
I know. You're so good with numbers as well. Obviously not the numbers on your clock. So, Andrew, what you need to do is get yourself a new phone. Because nowadays, these wonderful smartphones, like whatever you have, an Android or an Apple, they update themselves. The problem is when you have an alarm clock next to the bed, which is an old clock, that doesn't update. But your phone will. So if you use your phone as an alarm, it will. You can't go wrong. I've said you can't go wrong. I'm sure you can go wrong, but Andrew, that's tickled me. Anyway, I hope you had a great time on your holiday. I look forward to catching up with you very soon. Where are we going to next? Glenn Snyder. Now, Glenn has sent in a couple of requests this week, actually. Sent in a request for a hymn, which we'll have now. But he also sent in a request for an organ piece. Let's start with the hymn, and then we'll have the organ piece before the top five.
I think Glenn Snyder actually weeks ago requested the Pascalia in C minor.
Yeah, well, we'll have that actually
sooner
than you might think. I'll do that in a recital very soon. So Glenn has requested, beneath the cross of Jesus, I fain would take my stand, the shadow of a mighty rock within a weary land, a home within the wilderness, a rest upon the way from the burning of the noontide heat and the burden of the day. The tune is called St. Christopher, and it was composed by Frederick Maker, and the words were by Elizabeth and Clefane, I think, perhaps. This is not a big hymn, so this gives us an opportunity just to explore some more of these quieter stops, I think, so we actually feel free to turn up your systems, your headphones, your hi-fis, because I'll just explore some of the quieter stops on this for this particular hymn. Thank you. Who was it who just said that? Jerry Hall just said, such a lovely early 20th century hymn. It's gorgeous, isn't it? Very simple, but very gorgeous. Daryl said, can we have the tune A Bridge next? Well, actually, Daryl, if you rewind and go back to when I played Be Thou My Guardian and My Guide, I actually did play the tune A Bridge earlier on today. So diverse that we are, we have so many hymns. Like, you name a hymn tune, I've played it. On the same day, even. So that was a request from Glenn Snyder, who requested Beneath the Cross of Jesus to the tune Saint Christopher. Cool, lovely, well done. Obviously that went down well. What good choice, Glenn. PGM Music is up next with a request called I Need Thee Every Hour. Most gracious Lord, no tender voice like thine can peace afford. And then the refrain is, I need thee, oh, I need thee, every hour I need thee. Oh, bless thee, oh, bless me, my Saviour, I come to thee. Jim, thank you very much for your 10 just now. That's a very kind of you, my friend. And also thank you for being a channel member for 3 months. Big shout out, actually, whilst I remember, to everyone who is a channel member. And of course, to everyone who is a Patreon as well. There are two ways that you can financially support Beauty and Sound regularly, both channel memberships and Patreon. Patreon, the reason I push people towards Patreon is because Patreon take less of a cut. So if you give me £30, for example, or $30, I get more of that than if you gave me £30 via YouTube, because YouTube take a slightly higher cut, basically. But either is okay. Whichever one you feel comfortable with, I appreciate it. I really do. So big shout out to you all. Good night, Ian. See you next time. Good. So I need the every hour to the tune Need. And this is a request from PGM Music. Two more hymns after this, which marks the end of our pre-requests. And then we go into our top five hymns tonight, which comes from Christopher Nelson. Five hymns here, which you'll all know because they're actually really well known, and it's a really good selection of music. And before we have that list of top five hymns, we'll have a piece of Bach. But for now, let's have I Need Thee Every Hour. Lovely. Lovely. Thank you very much, PGM. Another hymn now. Let's just get these next two hymns played. So King Laudrup has requested a really wonderful tune, which a lot of people know. It's a very well-known tune, well-known words. It's Come Ye Faithful, Raise the Anthem, to the tune Unser Herrscher, Herrscher, I think, actually.
Herrscher, yeah.
Yes. I blame the iPad because it was taking a long time to focus there. So when it initially loads, it goes fuzzy, and when it's loaded, it goes to high quality. But until it's loaded, it was fuzzy, and I couldn't quite see what the letters were. But I sort of could see it in my mind. Thank you very much, Paul, for your $4.99. That's very kind. I really appreciate it. And also thank you very much to Bill for your $5. That's very kind. There we go. Doug Alderdice has just written it in the chat, a.k.a. Neander. So, King Laudrup, there are 6 verses in this hymn, but if you don't mind, we'll only have 3 verses because they're quite long verses. I hope you don't mind. Okay, let's go. So Come Ye Faithful, Raise the Anthem. And then Ty? I don't know where Ty came from. Finally, we have the final request, for now at least, by Carmen Foster. Carmen is one of our favourite hymn requesters. I think, Carmen, you might be in the lead for your hymn requests. I think it'd be an interesting poll, wouldn't it? Who has requested the most hymns?
Carmen's just done another super chat one for later as well.
Oh, well, I think Carmen's well in the lead.
I think Daniel Kubacki's up there.
Daniel Kubacki gets one in every week. Who else is a regular? Well, we got Benjamin Yao is a regular.
Yeah.
There's lots of people who are regulars. It's so wonderful to have regular people. Just had a message from Donald. Today I celebrate my 646,464,000th hour with God. Every hour. I would see what you mean. Aww. So 74 years. Oh, that's very
clever.
Happy
birthday, Donald. Yeah. It was Hugo's birthday yesterday. He's only two.
Yeah, that's significantly fewer hours, isn't it?
Just a few.
Even as I wondered, Almighty God pursued me. I thank you all for being part of my celebration of BC today.
Oh, and thank you, Donald. He's just sent a part two of two as well.
Oh, wow. Well, Donald, honestly,
he's given a dollar for every year, nearly, of his life.
Thank you.
Every hour of his life. You'd be very excited if he'd given a dollar for every hour of his life.
Yeah, that would solve lots of our BIS sort of financial problems, wouldn't it? That would pay for a new camera that's broken. right, final request before we have before we go into our top five tonight. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice. As I say, this is a request from Carmen. Let me fire it up on the iPad here.
Yes, it was Hugo's birthday yesterday, everyone. We took him for a ride on a steam train, which he really enjoyed. He really enjoyed himself.
And we all enjoyed it, didn't we?
And he spent the morning splashing in puddles, which is one of his favourite things to do at the moment. So I would say that for Hugo, that was a good day.
Along with pizza, because that's his favourite food.
He had pizza and bolognese, spaghetti bolognese, yeah, his favourite foods.
kicked his ball, splashed some puddles, saw some trains, got a new car for a present. He had a great day, I think. It was a success. He didn't really take to his cake, though, did he?
He's
in this sort of age where if he doesn't like the look of something, he won't eat it. But he had some today. He forgot that he didn't like the look of it.
So he was nabbing the chocolates off the top yesterday, but today he went for the cake and he decided actually it was quite nice.
He went for it. He did. He went for it. Right, so here we go. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice and it's told thy love to me. But I long to rise in the arms of faith and be closer drawn to thee. Final request before we get into our top five. I just saw the last, the refrain is actually really relevant, which is why it's a good hymn for Lent. It's, draw me nearer, nearer, blessed Lord, to the cross where thou hast died. Draw me nearer, 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 blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. There we go. Now, we're going to have a short organ piece. This is about 4 minutes long. Actually, a bit less than that, actually. And then we're going to go into our top five. Now, this organ piece was almost requested by Glenn Snyder.
Almost.
Glenn requested Wir glauben all. Einem Gott. Wir glauben all. And I got it wrong again, I'll say it for the third time. Wir glauben all an einem Gott. These E's and the I's are difficult for my dyslexia. He had requested BWV 740. I looked at it, Glenn, but I don't play it, actually. And it's not one that I ever have played. But there is, and I know you requested the other this BWV 740 for a very specific reason, but there is a very well-known setting of the same text by Bach, BWV 680, which comes from the Clavier Übung. And I'll play that, if you don't mind. Actually, it's been nice to get to play this again. This is actually normally for Trinity Sunday. Wir glauben all is actually the, as far as I'm aware, it's the creed. We believe in one God. But anyway, we say the creed every Sunday, don't we, at Mass? So it's sort of relevant for every Sunday. So wir glauben all an einem Gott. We all believe in one God. go.
Nala's arrived.
Oh, here comes trouble.
She arrived to hear the bark.
Here comes an almost certain chapter of chaos. Right, so now that takes us nicely into tonight's top five. Gregory, thank you very much for your $10 just now. And Rudy, or Rowdy, has just used his highlighted message as a member to say thanks, Percy.
He's a member of the Percy Whitlock tier.
Ah.
So maybe that's why he says Percy.
Got it. Cool. So let's now go into our top five. This week requested by Christopher Nelson.
So Christopher is listening live, but I don't believe he has a YouTube handle, so I don't think he can participate in the live chat. But he sent me an email at about 8:20 saying he was really excited and was listening.
Fantastic.
So hello, Christopher.
Hi, Christopher, and sorry that you've had to wait so long. But good things do come to those who wait. So this has been in our inbox since October of last year. He says, hi, Richard Caroline, I hope you are well, and I'm delighted that your endeavours with BIS are going so well. Although I do not currently have an account on YouTube, I watch your content regularly and thought I would enter into the spirit of VC and submit my top five hymns. So here they are. Right, so the first one, starting at number five, working down to number one, is Holy God, We Praise Your Name, to the tune Grüße Gott, Wir Loben Dich. I have heard this quite a few times, played by Fraser Gardshaw, as I believe it is a very popular hymn in Germany. But I just love the melody. Well, it is a very nice tune. It is a very beautiful melody. And it is very well known in Germany. It is, by all accounts, a German chorale. It's not a Lutheran chorale, I don't think. So let's have the flutes to begin with. Four verses of Holy God, We Praise Your Name.
Thank you.
I was just a little bit active in that hymn because I was there's a vibration on that low F. Oh, it's now stopped doing it. I don't know what note it's on and what rank it's on, but there's a vibration in the room somewhere on that F, and we're trying to work out where it was coming from. I said, it's over there, and Caroline said, no, it's over there. I'm like, no, it's over there. It's over there somewhere. Number four in Christopher's list is immortal, invisible, God only wise. To the tune St. Dino. A favourite of mine, which I first heard during the Commonwealth Day service in March 2020. Again, as the previous hymn, he said in the previous hymn, I am very fond of the melody. Well, so am I, actually. Chris, we had this one this morning at my church. So it's nice to play this one again. Two times today. Immortal, Invisible is number four in Chris's top five hymns.
Painting.
Very kind.
That
thank
was
you.
The wither and perish, but naught changes thee, wasn't it? I just knew where you were.
Well, a bit of context. We blossom and flourish as leaves on the tree. That grows, gets bigger and bigger. And then, of course, when we get into the autumn, and wither and perish. But nothing changeth thee. So he is always there, always present, always strong. We, just like leaves on the tree, fall off the tree and perish. it is a good opportunity for some word painting, as I demonstrated to my organ scholar this morning. I said, watch this. Right, number three in Chris's list. Number three is a favourite here on BIS. It's For All the Saints. So my twin brother Phil first heard this hymn whilst watching the state funeral of George Bush and pointed it out to me. I subsequently heard it whilst watching a recording of the Royal British Legion Festival of Remembrance at the Royal Albert Hall. So the tune has a personal connection with me. For all the saints who from their labours rest, all who by faithful before the world confessed.
Nola, so, you've sat on Daddy's lap for this hymn before, haven't you?
Yeah, she did, didn't she?
She's still in the room. She's just sitting behind the camera, yeah, washing her leg on the table.
She's happy to be behind the cameras today, in the background, helping with a bit of the production.
She is here.
In the production team. She's in the director's chair. So as I'm playing this, it's a really good opportunity to do our traditional thing here on BIS. Please give me a plus one and your location. And as I know this hymn pretty well, I'll be able to look up at the chat to see who's in. And it's also wonderful for people watching. Maurice, before you go, you've got to give plus one in your location. People watching back can also see who's in. So For All the Saints Who From Their Labours Rest, with your plus one and your location. This is number three in Chris's list. Just having a quick look at my audio again, just to make sure. Notice something which I might be able to quickly fix.
Welcome to Fancy Schmancy, who's a new listener today. That was For All the Saints.
It was.
The hymn tune.
It was indeed For All the Saints. Let's go to this one.
One of Nala's favourites, eh, Nala?
Paste that. Right, quick audio test for everybody. Let's see if this works. So, I'm just going to play one more verse of this for the audio, okay? Then this will fix the audio. So, last verse once more. Better?
Oh, Maurice, you're still here. I thought you were on Mars.
Come on, James, can you let me know, please?
Good, James, right. James has said perfect in capitals. Maurice thinks good. You've got distortion, but Maurice is on Mars, so I don't think we can trust him. Probably everything's distorted on Mars.
Yeah. Anyway, so let's now go into number two in Chris's list. This is this was played at the Queen's funeral. It is a very well known tune, very well known, the most well known words, I think, of any hymn or of any psalm. It's "The Lord's My Shepherd," which is obviously Psalm 23. There are a couple of tunes that we could have. Let's go for the one that we normally have here in this country, the tune Crimond. I love it how people are saying distorted, people are saying better, people are saying perfect. It's whatever thus, you know, it's always some people saying one thing and some other people saying another thing. No distortion from James Palmer. Good, we'll have to listen back.
We'll have to stick with it as James is producing tonight.
Is in charge.
James is going to have the casting vote.
James is the boss.
Well, Nala's actually the boss, but she hasn't got an opinion on this issue.
She doesn't look very boss-like right now. She looks like she's pretty much asleep. I think she's just relaxed. Right, so number two, yes, "The Lord's My Shepherd." This hymn is a personal favourite of my mum's. I also particularly enjoyed the melody when it is played well. No pressure there. Thank you. Gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous, isn't it, that particular hymn? Right, so what... let me just think about this for a moment.
Still tinkering with his audio, folks.
I've just made one more tweak, and then... Well, I like it to be right, because we've got a big voluntary coming up. A big voluntary, so I need the audio to be right for the big voluntary.
Oh, it is big, isn't it?
Big one.
You were practicing it earlier, it's loud.
No, heaven forbid, after doing some practice. Number one now in Chris's list. As Daniel Kabaki has just said, this is a really good list. It's a really strong list, and actually what works well about it is that people know these hymns, so that people always like that. But at the same time, people also like to hear new hymns.
I think it's a nice contrast too. So you go from For All the Saints into The Lord's My Shepherd.
Yeah.
So it's not just one big loud list. It's a mixture of
it's
moods.
It's a good mixture indeed. So number one, we actually had this. We had it last week, I think. He simply says this, just a real favourite within the family. I think this is a favourite in most families, isn't it? It's Cymhrontha. Guide me, O thou great Redeemer, pilgrim through this barren land. I am weak, but thou art mighty. Hold me with thy powerful hand. Bread of heaven, feed me till I want no more. Want no more, feed me till I want no more. And then Chris signs off by saying, I hope you find these submissions useful and look forward to hopefully hearing them in a future VC. Well, it was very much in the future, Chris. But we got there eventually. So we'll have this, and it's just a quick, whilst it's on my mind, an opportunity to shout out to anyone who has yet to submit. Heck, if anybody wants to resubmit another top five list, feel free, I don't mind. We're nearly at Easter, actually. So next week is Palm Sunday. And then week after that's Easter, isn't it? So Easter is 2 weeks today.
Josh is devising an Easter top five for the week after Easter.
Fantastic. I should say, actually, that's the a quick bit of advertising. Easter Day VC will be pre-recorded. Easter hymns, obviously. But Easter hymns on one of our great cathedral organs. So last year, if you remember, we had Easter from Salisbury Cathedral. So we had an organ recital from Salisbury and then virtual church from Salisbury. This year, we have an Easter weekend from a Lincoln Cathedral. Lincoln has a wonderful four-manual Willis organ. The cathedral itself is one of the nicest cathedrals in the entire world. It's regularly voted as one of people's favourite cathedrals here in England. And when you go and see it, it's easy to see why, because it's gorgeous.
Massive.
And the organ is just tremendous as well. So Easter weekend, BIS this year, organ recital, organ demonstration, organ recital, and a virtual church from Lincoln. So that's what I'm in the middle of putting together now. And what a wonderful experience that is. So, number one, guide me, O thou great Redeemer. Let's check these balances again now.
Bobby, don't walk on the pedal board, please. Thank you.
Thank you. Great. Well, that marks the end of the top five. So
well
thank
done,
you very
Chris
much, Chris, for sending that in. That was a wonderful list. I think everyone can agree that that was a really good list. Number five, Holy God, we praise thy name. Number four, Immortal, Invisible, God only wise. Moving into number three, For all the saints who from thy labours rest. Number two didn't quite make the top spots this week. The Lord's my shepherd. And sitting out right in front, in the lead, guide me, O thou great Redeemer, to the tune, Come Run With That.
I think you might have fixed the distortion issue.
Good. Excellent.
According to Good Chappie, who's generally quite reliable with these things.
Yes. Well, I've now done the top five. I've now done the pre-requests.
All right.
I now need to play the live requests. So this is at the point where people watching live have made requests and I need to play them. So where do we go first, producer extraordinaire?
I think Bill Ratey first. Love Divine to the tune Beecher.
Okay, tune. Where do I find that then?
I'll find it for you. I think it's in the 82 hymnal.
Okay, that will be good.
I think everybody loves Blind Van, but I think someone just, might not even have been Bill, someone he knows wanted this tune for.
Yeah, we have had Blind Van quite a lot recently,
470.
Haven't we? Let's just make sure that glass doesn't get knocked
in
over.
This hymnal, 470.
If you take that glass away as well so it doesn't get knocked.
Oh, it's the wrong words, but it's the right tune, Beecher, on the left.
That one there.
Yeah. Love Divine, or not. It fits, doesn't it? It does fit the...
Yeah, so can you take the glass, please? So Love Divine or Love's Excelling, to the, you all know the words to that one, don't you? But to the tune here, Beecher, as requested by Bill Ratey. And then we're inching closer to tonight's wonderful voluntary. I can't wait to play it because I haven't played it for a long time. The last time it appeared on BIS was from Gloucester Cathedral. I'll give you a little bit of a tip as to what it is. Not played by me, played by somebody else.
Thank you.
In the next hymn, there's a version with a refrain, a version without a refrain. Yes. We know all about hymns with versions without the refrain, don't we, here? Because I often miss out the refrain unintentionally. But this one actually has two versions.
I have put out a shout out to Paul Sulzbacher.
Yeah.
Do you know, is it the refrain version or not?
So Paul Sulzbacher has requested this one, is that
yeah,
right?
Okay. I believe so.
Peace is flowing like a river, flowing out through you and me, spreading out into the desert, setting all the captives free. And then there's a refrain. Let's have the refrain. Let it flow through me, let it flow through me. Let the mighty peace of God flow out through me. Let it flow through me. Let it flow through me. That's getting into a bit of a tongue tangle. That. Let the mighty peace of God flow out through me.
Hugo was trying to say purple bubble earlier. No, purple apple. And was he? He got himself in a bit of a tongue twister.
Tongue tangle.
Purple apple. Purple apple.
That's advanced.
And is he it, did a...
Oh my gosh.
And he got himself a bit muddled tongue twister.
Did you see Nala just jump up then?
I saw her. I don't know if the viewers did.
Oh, I don't know. I certainly saw her. Right, here we go. Let's
Nala
go.
Nala is on the organ, everybody.
Anything could happen. Now let's go for I love the oboe on the resi. I want to use that stop.
PGM Musica says normally without refrains.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, but we haven't heard from Paul, so I'll leave it up
Hopefully.
To you.
Hopefully. Well, I don't know. Take a gamble. I actually lost count in that because I was enjoying it. I'm not sure whether I played it four times or five times or even six times. But there were five verses there. So I think I nearly got the number right.
So So I think we are now on to our final super chat requested hymn tonight.
Already?
Which comes in from Carmen Foster.
Carmen Foster? Oh, well, I don't know that name. Carmen Foster's never requested the hymn before. Yeah, we have had this hymn a few times.
Well, yes. When you do them the organ marathon, definitely.
Yeah, and so
it's one of the American national hymns, isn't it?
It's under the national section.
You'll have to play them, you know, those trumpet bits.
But there are some arbitrary trumpet bits.
Arbitrary. But they love it. Yeah, but we've had this discussion before.
I know we have, but my point is, I don't think what's written in here is what should be played.
Ah.
So I don't know what should be played.
Ah.
All I have is just some really quite random triplets, which do nothing to the music.
Ah.
I wish there was more to it.
Well, we need to go online and listen to a version of it from somewhere like Washington Cathedral. And
it's just that, it's just preparing secondary dominant to there, okay.
He's practicing your hymn request,
I know,
Carmen.
But Carmen, I always play a wrong chord and it really annoys me because it's really badly typeset. So, God of our fathers, whose almighty hand leads forth in beauty all the starry band, pa 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 pop, of shining worlds in splendour through the skies, pa 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 pop, our grateful songs before thy throne arise. It literally goes pa 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 pop.
I think you need to do it.
I will. You know,
We're not American. We can't make that decision. As I remember before, the Americans very strongly believe they should be in. So it's not up to us Brits to leave them out.
Oh, no.
That would be like,
I wouldn't dare.
That would be like them cutting half of Pomp and Circumstance March by Elgar.
Hopefully someone will be able to help me out. Some American watching who knows this hymn, who's an organist.
Daniel Kabaki says the trumpet bits are in the score, look.
But I'll play it.
You would know, Daniel would know. He's probably heard it played on the Wanamaker.
Yeah, but I'll play it as printed. And then we'll see. And I need help with this. I genuinely need help. Okay?
They're already doing the Richard pop, confused pop, pop, face pop. Emoji.
Is there like a parp emoji or something?
Pop. That was a trumpet.
We should get a parp emoji. That's the sound a trumpet makes. Anyway, parp. Okay, let's get some parps ready. There we go. Get those fired up. Let's see what happens. Help me out, guys.
Thank you.
Logan and Donna, who wanted a tuba mirabilis or more trumpet, we don't actually have a tuba on this organ, so we couldn't do anything there.
Yeah, there aren't any tubas
perhaps
on this organ.
Perhaps, Richard, on Independence Day, you should record that hymn with on to somewhere like Dulange, with look, all
I,
the...
I was giving that hymn my all, so much so that my glasses ended up here.
They enjoyed it, and good chappy noticed that you got all the chords right.
Yeah, there is, I'm sure, one of these hymn books that we have, it's not this one, but there's a misprint on that chord.
Oh dear.
Where it goes to G flat major.
No, I think that was the free version that we used to use before we were kindly given
this. Yeah, you're right. What it was a.
It was the one I just printed from the hymnary. Yeah, I think that had a howler of an accidental.
I didn't know the hymn, so I didn't know what the chord should have been.
And I think it stuck. It got into your muscle memory because that was what we used for the first 2 years until we were kindly gifted the hymn of 1982.
I know. Right. So I think we've got through all of the requests now.
I think we have, James. Would you agree with me?
I'll give a quick shout out to people who have donated very kindly. John, Margot, Jim, Gregory, Rudy, Donald, twice, Carmen.
Oh yeah, Gregory Potter sent
Margot
super chat,
again,
but it was
Paul,
the bark icon with
Bill,
wearing shades.
And Jim. So thank you very much for those requests, guys. That's very, very, very generous. We're up to date. A Bill, imagine it at St Paul's Cathedral in London. Wouldn't it be nice to record that organ? Hopefully one day we'll record there. That would be a dream coming true.
Thank you very much, Margaret, for sending us money via PayPal. That's very kind.
Oh, wow. Yes, thank you very much. I don't get PayPal notifications on any of my devices.
You used to.
I don't, but I don't anymore.
Because when you did the marathon,
I think it's since I've got
in.
This watch, actually.
Oh, no.
I think this iWatch is... Because you get notifications on here. Those people who with an iWatch know. But I don't get PayPal notifications on here. So I think somehow it's messed it up. Anyway, listen to this. No, you left at the wrong time. Listen to this clunk. You hear that clunk? Probably not. Oh, no, that's not even the right clunk. The right clunk is this one. Yeah. That's the voluntary. So the kitchen sink is now out. We are now going to have some Vienne as tonight's voluntary. It's from Symphony No. 2 in E minor. Now, I recorded this. If you enjoy this particular movement, I recorded it at Gloucester Cathedral. There was no other organ. Some organs in this country would be just perfect for this piece. Perfect. Gloucester Cathedral was one of them, with the previous organ. And I managed to record Jonathan Hope playing the entire symphony on that organ. It sounds wonderful, wonderful. So if you have a spare half an hour, I would highly, highly recommend going to listen to that, because it just sounds astonishing. It's a cyclic symphony, which means that the main tune...
We clunked again.
I am, because I'm going to demonstrate the tune. The main tune in the first... One of the tunes in the first movements does this. Okay. Now, in the final movement, which I haven't actually got here, but in the final movement, that tune comes back. But it's actually really exciting, because here... This is the rhythm. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. But in the final movement, it's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. It's on the beat. It's really, really powerful. So if you have half an hour spare, get yourself a coffee, headphones on, listen to Jonathan Hope's recording of him of playing that. And if you do, if anyone does do that, please leave a comment on that video to say that you've done it, and I'll leave you a personal reply.
To everyone requesting César Franck, the complete organ works of César Franck are available on Beauty and Sound. Just look it up.
What are they asking for?
Nothing in particular. Just it hasn't been super chatted. It's just been in the chat. A few people asking for César Franck.
Yep.
So we can't play any tonight, but the whole complete organ works are on the channel.
On BIS.
On
recorded BIS. By many, many organists.
Great organists.
Very
indeed.
Good organists. Here we go. So here's Vien, the Allegro Risoluto Ma Non Troppo Vivo, first movement of his second symphony. Here we go. What angle should we start on?
I think the multi-view.
Multi-view?
With the church.
Have you got your angles ready?
Because you've got the kitchen sink.
She's slacking over here.
If you said you've put the kitchen sink
she's
out,
sat
you've
on
got
the pregnancy ball bouncing
you've
around.
You've got to have the kitchen sink of camera angles,
okay,
haven't
well, you? Over to you. Tell me when. Thank you. Well, some of those notes were in the right order. That was the first movement of the second symphony by Louis Vierne. There, I had to then suddenly switch from playing the Vierne to then thinking about changing cameras because my camera lady has disappeared to go and look after our little man. This is one of the things that we have to do here when producing and doing a live stream. Play the organ, talk to you, and change the angles. It's a lot to think about. You don't get trained to do that in organ scholarships. You should be trained to change angles. What a piece that is. Isn't that really amazing? So if you do like it, go and check it out on the Gloucester Cathedral organ recital given by Jonathan Hope. He plays the entire symphony. And listen out in the final movement. When the tune comes back. It's a very, very powerful moment, actually. Well, thank you all very much for watching. Jerry, you've just given me 50. Wow, thank you very much, Jerry. That's very kind, very kind. Logan Barry just says, you need more limbs. Organists have to be part octopus to play. I think you're absolutely right. I wish I had at least 4 more arms to change the angles for a start, Logan, and also to just to pull out the stops. You know, on a Kavai Kull, you wouldn't have the luxury of these advanced buttons. So we are spoiled here. And it would be hard to do that by oneself. Not impossible, of course, because on the French organs, there are lots of ventils. Ventils essentially disengage things, you know, disengage the reeds. They have couplers, just like we have couplers. But they can't push stops in and add stops like these advanced buttons do. Anyway, so I'm going to draw it to a close there now. I hope you've enjoyed the show tonight. I've had a great time. I've had a really great time. I love playing this organ. In fact, when I bring people round to play the organ here at BIS, this is the organ that I actually show them, because you have to believe me that when people play this organ in the room itself, it just sounds like you're in Saint-Ouen, basically. It just sounds so raw and very exciting. So this is the organ I load up. It sounds amazing in here. So next week, usual, I might even give it a recital next week. I'll see how I feel. Because I've got a lot of Lincoln recording to do, editing to do this week. A lot of editing to do. Because I really want that to be as good as it possibly can. And I'm in the middle of editing the audio now, and I'm really happy with the way it's sounding, honestly. I think you'll be really, really impressed with that audio. I'm really pleased with it. So until then, until next week, I will say, and I'll also say cheerio on behalf of Caroline. I just knocked Bobby, because Bobby's just appeared, to say bye-bye, haven't you? You appeared in one of my videos this week. Should we say goodbye? You're looking up at the screen. Whoa, come on, get down. There we go then. I'll say goodbye. Good night, everyone. I appreciate you all. I love you all. I'll see you next week. Take care.